I know. We're meeting them tomorrow 6 o'clock. I know they mean tomorrow 6 o'clock. Yeah, I know that. Sorry. So, yeah, that's everything. Thanks a lot. Okay. Before I go, can I just quickly have a vote? Who's in favour of this, and who thinks a good idea that it should be included in the initial statement? Read it again. Okay. The present unjust and exploitative economic system also pollutes land, sea and air. It's causing massive loss of natural species and environments, and is accelerating humanity towards irreversible global warming. We call upon individuals, organizations and governments to co-create a sustainable economic system that benefits present and future generations. I think that needs to be included because there's a massive favor of this. And I think...
Excuse me, is your block not something that could be discussed at their meeting tomorrow?
This should be a movement for political power. In order to attain that, we need coherent messages. Anything elected with people like us in charge would naturally have incredibly good green credentials. Do not dilute the message. This is a message and a movement for change. For change will then empower the green movement. Do not overcomplicate the pudding.
Can I add to that?
Quickly,
can I make a quick message?
You have 10 seconds.
If everyone looks at the Wall Street movement that created this movement, you will see that green credential, acting on climate change, acting on averse towards future oil that's running out, is a core of that movement. That's why it should be a core of the London movement too. Thank you very much.
Okay, bear with us folks. This is direct democracy and we allow a plurality of views. Do we have any more updates? Okay. There was not consensus at that point, I agree.
Okay, everyone, this isn't a formal update from an actual working group, but my name's Michael, I'm from the National Campaign Against Fees and Cuts, and we are the organisation that's organising one of the many organisations that's organising the National Student Demo on November the 9th. It's going to be the next big march in London. It's incredibly important. We'll be marching on the city, and Occupy London Stock Exchange has given us some real political weight. We're hoping that we can do the same for you. And what we did today was we had our London regional meeting. It was small but productive, and we have come up with a few action points that I'd like to see a temperature check on to kind of concretise the solidarity work and the practical work that we're doing with you and that you're doing with us and that we are doing together, since we're kind of the same thing. And basically there are 4 points that I've come here to ask a temperature check. Firstly, everyone here lives, at least when they don't live here, they live somewhere else, and you all have local schools, and we need to organise mass school student walkouts in order to build a demonstration. We found thousands and thousands of students on the streets. So, what we're asking for is help leafleting in local schools, where you're from, in order to build walkouts there. So, temperature check on that. Good. Anybody massively disagree with organising walkouts from schools? Good. Okay. Happy with that. The other thing that we're asking for is help with press coverage, because you guys have an absolutely enormous amount of press coverage going on right now, and given that the 9th of November National Student Demonstration is one of the things that's going to happen in the city very, very soon. It's the next kind of big thing in terms of mass dissent in Britain on the 9th of November. We'll be working with press teams in order to make sure that our stuff goes through your press teams and your stuff goes through our press teams. Consensus on that? Temperature check? Anybody massively disagree with us and you cooperating in terms of press? No, good. Okay, third thing, very quickly, fly posting all over London for the national demo. We'll be able to deliver quite cool, snazzy, arty posters designed by students for the national demo to here on Tuesday, and we'd like teams of people going around central London, students and occupiers, sticking them up everywhere. Consensus on that? Great. Also, anybody massively disagree with fly posting? Great. And fourthly, one of the things that we'd like to loot, and this is a more strategic political thing, is I'm sorry, I've probably overstayed my minute here. This is the last thing I'm going to say, is that essentially what you've seen across Europe is that a lot of the sort of town square occupations, which there have been a lot of students in, and there are a lot of students here today, have said, look, we've occupied our town squares, so let's keep that going, and let's occupy our campuses. Now, after the 9th of November National Student Demo, there will be a lot of mobilised, politicised students again, and the idea is to hold another wave of campus occupations. So what we're thinking of doing is coordinating a call for campus occupations from the National Campaign Against Fees and Cuts, from various other student groups, and from the Occupy London Stock Exchange movement to go and occupy campuses. Can I see consensus on that? Anybody massively disagree with that? Good, that's all four consensus points. Please listen to further announcements at future general meetings in terms of how to get involved exactly. But thank you very much. Cheers.
And we're about to get an update from the Outreach Working Group, and I would just like to emphasise to the Outreach Working Group that the nature of tonight's discussion is to help them.
Okay, yeah, this is just a brief report back. We had, I hope you'll all agree, a successful outreach and outreach assembly on Saturday afternoon. We will be producing a new leaflet with up and coming events this week, including Tent City Youth Programme. We've got a proposal for a meeting and outreach event for Thursday around 5 p.m. for people, for workplace struggles, people in workplaces to come and meet and have an event here. And we want to organise outreach training for people who want to speak at other places like colleges or workplaces or community groups. So we're planning to produce some material for people, if they're stuck for what to say, come to us for advice and training.
I've been asked by the facilitator to kind of clarify a question that's just come through. About the 9th of November National Student Demo, we are meeting, the meeting point is 12 noon at the University of London Union on Mallet Street in Bloomsbury. University of London Union on Mallet Street in Bloomsbury, 12 noon on the day, and we'll be marching on the city. We are in negotiations with the police tomorrow. The police have already told us that they may be looking to put a ban on our protest going into the square mile. So we will be looking to the Occupy LSX movement again for solidarity when we tell them that whatever we do is likely to happen anyway. Cheers.
Okay, just to remind those of you who've come a bit late to the meeting, this is the point where I'm going to suggest some ideas for us to discuss. Experience tells us that 10 is about the right size for a group to discuss. And then you have half an hour to talk about it, and then we'll ask one person from each group, if they want to feedback with their three key points. After that, we will have shout-outs. So if there's something, you're organising something, or you want to express solidarity with something, or you've lost your wallet, then come and talk to Amy, and you will get your chance at the microphone at the end of the meeting. Is everybody happy with that? Okay, thank you. All right, so the theme of tonight's political meeting, the General Assembly is a political meeting, and we want to talk about politics. In support of the outreach group, the process group thought that outreach was an important thing for us to consider tonight. How are we outreaching? Is there more that we can do? What can you do as an individual? What can we do as different groups of individuals? So I'm going to read out some different suggestions that were made at the process group. And as I do, I'd like to take a temperature check on them to see that we'll have them as discussion points. Is that okay? All right, here we go. Outreach. Workplace outreach. Outreaching to other people. Temperature check means help me. You either no or yes. Young people. Faith groups. Unemployed people, pensioners, universities, social networks, Okay, I'm just going to read through that list again, and what would be really helpful if one person would stand up to help to facilitate that group, and that group will assemble around that person. Are you ready? Okay. Who wants to discuss workplace outreach? Okay, stand up. Okay, so the workplace outreach group will happen here. Young people, who would like to facilitate that group? This gentleman over here. Stand up, please. Okay, so the young people group will happen over there. Faith groups. Would you stand up, please, sir? This gentleman here will take the faith group discussion and assemble around him. Unemployed people. That gentleman there would like to facilitate that, so assemble around him. Pensioners. If nobody stands up to facilitate the group, it won't happen. Pensioners. Okay, this gentleman will facilitate pensioners. Universities. This lady here. Can I just say to you, woman over there, might it be an idea, because we've got quite a lot of groups assembling here, if you wouldn't mind having your group just over here? And the last one, social networks. Okay, social networks up there in the corner. I'm just going to read through them again, and when I read through them, can each person stand up?
Can we add to another group?
Oh yes, and of course, if you want to add another group, this is your chance.